We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello, welcome you on this online lecture platform provided by GTU. So myself, Professor D.K. Mehta, Assistant Professor in Chemical Engineering Department, Ely College, Morbi. Today, the topic of this lecture is reflux ratio. See, the reflux ratio is important terminology in distillation mass transfer operation. So we study this in the subject mass transfer operation 2 in the 6th semester. The subject code is 216-0501. Also, it is useful in the 8th semester, the subject that is elective 2 multi-component distillation, the subject code is 218-0505. So this is also useful to the 8th semester chemical engineering students, right? So the content of today's lecture is, first we understand what is reflux, then we understand what is reflux ratio, then we understand minimum reflux ratio, total reflux and optimum reflux ratio. And then we have three questions. So what you understand and maybe your concept regarding this reflux ratio will be much clearer. So the distillation, right? So just let's start. What is distillation? The distillation is that mass transfer operation in which we separate components by exploiting their difference in boiling point by adding and removing heat. Okay, so you can see in this distillation column, feed is entered, right? At the top, we are getting overhead product, right? So in the overhead product, it passes to condenser, right? It's cooled. Now it's sent to reflux drum, right? So now part of this overhead vapor is sent back to the distillation column and part is sent back, taken out as a final product, right? So this part of that overhead vapor taken back and sent back to the distillation column is known as reflux, right? So the part of overhead vapor sent back to the distillation column is known as reflux, and part of overhead vapor taken as final product is known as distillate, right? So this is reflux and this is overhead product, or we can say final product, that is distillate. And now the ratio of this reflux to distillate is known as reflux ratio R. So that R is equal to L by D, right? So reflux is always in it is in molar flow rate, right? And whereas reflux ratio does not have any unit, right? So now come to the next point, minimum reflux ratio. See, we sent in distillation, we sent component feed mixture into the distillation column. So to get desired separation, we need a number of theoretical stages. When I say number of theoretical stages, for tray tower, it is a number of trays, and for PEC tower, it is a tower height, right? So we need, we cannot have zero stages. We need some stages, and also we required some reflux ratio, right? So what could be the minimum reflux ratio? So minimum, at minimum reflux ratio, the distillation column requires infinite number of theoretical stages for desired separation. I repeat, at minimum reflux ratio, the distillation column requires infinite number of theoretical stages. That means to have a finite number of theoretical stages, we need a reflux ratio slightly higher than this minimum reflux ratio, right? And then it is possible, right? So at minimum reflux ratio, the operating cost is minimum. What this operating cost includes, see, cost of cooling medium of condenser, heating medium for reboiler, power for a reflux pump is minimum. Why it is so? So if you look at, if my reflux is minimum, so what is total amount of component should be handled in distillation column? So feed plus reflux, right? So feed is constant, as we assume that it is a steady state continuous operation. So now if my reflux is lower, right, so whatever my condenser duty or reboiler duty is minimum. Also, the reflux power for reflux pump is also minimum, right? So everything of this is minimum. Also, I have to handle lower amount of fluid, right? So that means my column diameter is also reduced, right? So at minimum reflux, all these things, the condenser duty, reboiler duty, reflux pump, power for reflux pump is minimum. Also column diameter is minimum, but the number of theoretical stages required is infinite, right? So as we know that if we increase reflux ratio, what happens? My number of theoretical stages is reduced. So if I want to ask you, what could be the minimum number of theoretical stages required, right, at for the desired separation, then you can say, sir, it will be the maximum reflux ratio. So this condition when happens, right? So think for a minute, take a pause and think for a minute when it is possible. See, so if you see that if you increase your reflux, right, your number of theoretical stages is reduced. So you can say that whatever may be the overhead product, everything will be sent back to the distillation column, right? Whatever may be the overhead product, you take it and send back to the distillation column. So there will not be any final product or display. That means display D is zero and L is, you can say, G, right? So at total reflux, all overhead vapor sent back to the column as reflux. At total reflux, minimum number of theoretical stages is required for desired separation. That means now for desired separation, this is the minimum number of theoretical stages. Beyond, if you still provide lower stages than this, then you never going to achieve a desired separation, right? So now as we know that if we increase the reflux, right, so reboiler load, condenser load, power for reflux, etc. will be increased and it will be maximum. So my operating cost is maximum, right? So as we I am increase my reflux, my reboiler load, condenser load and power for reflux pump will be increased. Also the maximum column diameter requires, right? Because what could be the maximum now fluid to be handled by a column? That is feet plus reflux, right? So what will be the reflux ratio at total reflux? See, remember, generally I see even in the examination, students made a mistake that they write down total reflux ratio. See, minimum reflux ratio is there, but this total is total reflux, not total reflux ratio. See, reflux is basically molar feed rate of the stream which is sent back to the column, right? So it is a total reflux. It is not a total reflux ratio. You should keep in your mind it is total reflux, not a total reflux ratio. So think what could be the reflux ratio at total reflux condition, right? Later on we will discuss, right? Okay, let's move to the optimum reflux ratio. See, now before sending that, okay, so see, we discussed that at minimum reflux ratio we require infinite number of theoretical stages. So if you take, say, your minimum reflux ratio, say it's 1.45, right? So if you say that if I have reflux ratio 1.5, then there will be some finite value of n is there, right? And other extreme, that you, if you increase reflux up to total reflux, you get some minimum number of n set. So it could have some n value. So the value of reflux ratio, right, from slightly higher to than the minimum reflux ratio to the total reflux, any combination of R and N is valid. Yes, technically it is valid. It shows that if your R is somewhat higher than RM, so that you get finite N up to your total reflux, right? So where you get NM, minimum number of theoretical stages. Any combination gives you desired separation, right? So technically you are correct. So what will you choose, right? What will you choose? See, as a any business, what is the basic purpose of any business is maximization of profit, right? It's a maximization of profit. Generally, maximization of profit comes with the reduction in cost. And even in the plant, many times you deal as an engineer, your job is to reduce the cost, right? So it's a very good field, and you will study everything this in optimization in detail, right? So from that, I can say that I have to choose that combination of R and N where my total cost is minimum, right? So when this happens, see, this is figure, this is you know, courtesy to the book from Introduction to Process Engineering and Design by Professor S.B. Thakur, sir, and B.I. Bhatt, sir. So a good book. In I think sixth semester you are using in PED, and also in the final year you are using in multi component distillation. So very good book. So in the sixth semester I prefer Trebal, but for this topic it is mentioned in this book, and relatively the author written in very you know simpler language so that the students from India can understand. So very thankful to Thakur sir. Okay, so let's see. So on the horizontal side, x-axis, we have a reflux ratio R, and on the vertical side or y-axis, you have annual cost in rupees per year. So mind well, generally we are, when you use for an author book, it's given in the dollar, right? So whether you are using Trebal, McCabe-Smith, Peter and Timmerhouse, so always you use these books, but whenever you write down answers in the examination, please write down rupees per year, because you are in India, not in US, right? So you can see that we start with RM, right? Because beyond, at RM also you require infinite number of theoretical stages, so beyond that the desired separation is not possible. So at RM, you know, your total cost, sorry, your operating cost, you can see at top you have total cost, at bottom the next curve is operating cost, and then your fixed cost, right? So your operating cost is minimum, right? And somewhere at higher point you have fixed cost. Now as you increase R, reflux ratio, you see that your operating cost is increasing, because it's a very simple thing. As you increase your R, your reflux L is increased. So the total flow fluid to be handled by distillation column is also increasing, because F plus L is increasing, right? So your condenser load, reboiler load, power for reflux, everything is continuously increasing. There is no doubt in it. Now, fixed cost, or you can say capital cost. What happens, right? No doubt, you increase your reflux, but what happens that the number of theoretical stages required for the desired separation and is drastically decrease. So the column diameter is increasing, but the decrease in this number of theoretical stages is quite high. So your ultimately fixed cost is reducing. Now this reduction in N is altogether offset this increase in operating cost and increase of column diameter, and also it's more than that. So my total cost is reducing, though my operating cost is increasing. Gradually further I increase R, same, my operating cost is always increasing, my column diameter is further increased, but there is a reduction in N, right? So it is always true that if I increase my R, my operating cost is increasing, my column diameter is increasing, and my N is decreasing. So now for as far as operating cost is concerned, all the parameters are increasing, but in case of fixed cost, the column diameter is increasing and N is decreasing. So the cost saving by the reduction of N is higher than this increase in the cost. My total cost is reducing. At some particular point, what happens that by increasing at value of R, the reduction in the value of N will be equal to the increase in operating cost and increase in fixed cost due to increase in column diameter, right? Now, beyond that, if we increase R, definitely my N is reduced, right? There is no doubt about it. But increase in operating cost and increase in column diameter will be higher, right? So now my total cost will increase, right? So you can say that reflux ratio where the total cost is minimum is known as optimum reflux ratio, right? So it is a desirable reflux ratio for me because I have a total cost, right? So I think I make a sense, right? So if you increase your R, your operating cost is increasing. In as far as fixed cost is concerned, your diameter is increasing, so that part of fixed cost is increasing as against your N is decreasing, right? So until and unless the reduction you by increasing R, if you getting the reduction N is higher than this increase in the operating cost and cost of column diameter, you just increase your R at some particular R, right? You get your total cost is minimum, that is your optimum reflux ratio. Beyond that, if you increase your R, your N will be reduced, but your total cost will be increased, right? Generally, optimum reflux ratio lie between 1.2 to 1.5 times the minimum ratio. See, this is you can say thumb rule. It is not always true. Sometimes in some system, in some difficult separation, it could be even higher, but it is a general trend, right? Now this value of optimum reflux ratio depends on the feed mixture, specified separation and operating condition. Okay, so I think you understand this is a very much important topic. You should this is not only for your sixth semester or you know, in the eighth semester when you study multi compound distillation, but it is you need to understand lifetime, right? Okay, so let's are you ready? Well, let's we discuss three questions. One each on minimum reflux ratio, total reflux and optimum reflux ratio. So maybe your doubt may be clear. I chosen this because this question or prepared so that whatever the general common mistake or misconception of the students are having, which can be removed. Okay, so first, the minimum reflux ratio in a distillation column corresponds to what? The options are optimum number of trays, minimum reboiler heat, maximum condenser cooling capacity and minimum number of trays, right? Pause the video and think, right? You can use even previous slides, right? Okay, so I think you got the answer. It is a minimum reboiler heat, right? So we know that everything with the operating conditions, right? Reboiler heat or condenser heat or powerful reflux pump are minimum at minimum reflux ratio. So it's easy. The second question, what is reflux ratio at total reflux? I you know told you when I explained you about total reflux, you should never write down total reflux ratio. It's a total reflux, it's a condition, right? So if it is a condition, then what will be my reflux ratio at total reflux? The options are zero, infinity, unity and none of the above, something else, right? If you see. So think and tell me. So pause the video and wait. Okay, see, I can give you directly answer, but without it, let's try to understand. What is total reflux? So at total reflux, whatever may be my overhead vapor, I will send back it to the distillation column, right? So my L is equal to G, right? So my D, the final product, final distillate product D is equal to zero, right? So I have L which has some finite value and my D is zero. Now what is my R? R is equal to L by D. So now my D is zero, right? So my R is infinity, right? You should remember, at total reflux, the reflux ratio is infinity, right? Remember, at minimum reflux ratio, we have an infinite, right? So that is not an infinite is possible. right? Because it's absolute number. So over here, infinity reflux ratio is possible because it is a ratio. So one if one component is zero, it is possible, right? And at that time, it is a condition of total reflux, right? The last question regarding optimum reflux ratio. Okay, so at operating optimum reflux ratio, four things. Operating cost is minimum, capital cost is minimum, both operating cost and capital cost is minimum, and neither operating nor capital cost is minimum, right? So think, you can refer that figure. So please note down all these things, right? And I mentioned you, so even if you have a book with you, with S.B. Thakur, the book by S.B. Thakur or by Trebal, you can open the diagram and you can think, right? Okay, so I think you determined the answer, right? So let me explain. At optimum reflux ratio, the total cost is minimum, right? So when my operating cost is minimum, naturally, my operating cost is very, very easy thing. At minimum reflux ratio, my operating cost is minimum. As I increase R, my operating cost is increasing, right? Now, regarding capital cost, right? We just move to this figure, sorry. So if you look at optimum reflux ratio, we discuss that the reduction in the value, reduction in the cost due to reduction in the value of N is equals to the increase in the operating cost plus increase in the cost due to increase in column diameter. So above optimum reflux ratio, my total cost is increasing, but my fixed cost is still continue to decrease, right? It still continue to decrease because now for fixed cost, my N and column diameter I have to check. And at certain point, if you see that the saving of amount due to reduction in E and is equal to the increase in the spending because of column diameter, right? And at some particular distance, if you increase R, your operating cost is also increased and your fixed cost is also increased, right? So you can say that your fixed cost is minimum at a reflux ratio somewhat higher than the optimum reflux ratio, right? So at total reflux, neither operating cost nor this fixed cost is minimum, right? But at so this fixed cost is minimum somewhat higher than the optimum reflux ratio, right? I think, is it clear to you, right? Now the question is, we move to this, okay? So operating cost is not possible, capital cost is minimum, not possible, both is minimum, so not possible, and neither operating nor capital cost is minimum. So D is correct. Remember, my total cost should be minimum, right? So at that point, this is the case. So I think I explained you very well. Operating cost is minimum when at minimum reflux ratio. The capital cost is minimum. From the graph, we can see that it is at the reflux ratio is somewhat higher than this optimum reflux ratio, and the total cost is lower at optimum reflux ratio. So at optimum reflux ratio, the total cost is minimum, but neither operating nor capital cost is minimum. I hope that you like this lecture, and your all the concepts are clear. Thank you very much.